Yo!
Thank you.
I'd found Boris Dime's ship. Rust had crept over the sides of the cargo steamer a long time ago. Boris Dime would be on board. I'd have to smoke half of his crew to even get near the gangplank. The guns were probably being kept in the hold, buried amidst the rats and oily water. Angie, tell me, how much did Dime cost you? I bet it was more than his name.
Max Payne.
Right the first time.
You're dead, punk.
You sure you're not confusing me with Boris here? But you are right, of course. Pretty soon we should get together and have a talk.
You son of a...
Pissing Punchinello off was a dangerous game. But when people get mad, they make mistakes. I should know. That's where I wanted Punchinello, mad enough to trip over his own feet. Preferably into a grave. Even with all this firepower, I figured I couldn't get to Punchinello at his manor. I could only hope that he wouldn't pass a chance to hear me beg to see he's won. This is Max Payne. I want to cut a deal.
Payne, you're a dead man.
That's what everybody keeps telling me. I got your ship and her cargo. I want to meet. No pain, no gain. Capiche?
You know my restaurant?
Yeah. I know it.
One out.
Punchinello's restaurant had seen better days. Snow was falling like ashes from post-apocalyptic skies, but that was outside. Things would soon get hot in the Don's restaurant. I knew it was a long shot, Angelo Punchinello actually showing up, but there was no crime in hoping. Chanella was burning to get me. He was trying to put out my flames with gasoline. Mobsters have been guarding a real treasure. The way out of this disco and
there he is!
Vlad had seen my smoke signals. The Mercedes was revving to go, almost drowning out the Banshee wail of the sirens.
You coming? We'll drop you off at the Punchinello Manor.
Sounds good to me.
When this is over, look me up. I could use a professional like you.
I'll keep that in mind.